Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijat, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism, a subject quite away from my field, but same it was away from the field of my father, who was a BSc only, science graduate, and he had no education or university or anything in theology. And he was very analytical. So being a science graduate, he analyzed many religious things. And his research I'm giving it to people. And in the previous table, we gave you one of his tabulated form of the spiritual states, and this number two table is give you on the more specific that the soul has four spiritual states, and the people who are Bhakt Kabir and other people, Christ Jesus, they belong to the fourth spiritual state. And that is the topmost. There is nothing beyond that. So these are, I have put them in a table form again so that you can know it. So here is the way I have done it again. This is the, they are according to four spiritual states, you know. There are four spiritual states, state communities and their classification characteristics. So there are four spiritual states and there are four also these Panth, we call it a community, religious communities. There is not only one religious community, there are four type of religious communities. So this is for the once born people, and this is for the twice born people who are doubting or who are clever looking for business, money, and these are the people who are sealed to serve God. And these are the people of the highest order of the fourth spiritual state. So this is the first one for the children normally, and when you go about 30 years old or so, the age at which Christ Jesus was baptized, then you enter into this one. So you become a seeker of his word. When you have sought it, then you put it into practice. And this is by the word of mouth, was in the case of Jesus, apostles. But in India, the Satan was very powerful. Then sword power was to be used. These people should use sword power. So, we can go through this one. I put this table in the description. So if you please print it out, and then it will be very helpful to you. So I'm going to go through this one, and I have introduced to you the four spiritual states. So four spiritual states, communities and their characteristics, four communities. The first community, we call it Panth in Punjabi, and Samaj in Hindi, and community in English, or Millat in Arabic. For the once-born children, moral law, they learn moral law, and is for ego, to subdue your ego. Moral laws are to subdue your ego. Otherwise, you will fighting with each other. So, ego is called humme. Virti. Virti means state. Bhume means ego. It's a purely body related. So it's purely body related, you know, on this are the flesh. It is a purely flesh type. And those who are holy don't do kill other people and harm other people. They are called holy son. So the second community are the panth, millet, etc. for the doubting, twice born, spiritual, twice born people who learn spiritual principles directed to mind. So they are not directed to physical body, but to your soul or mind, which we call man in Punjabi, man birti, or we call nafs in Arabic. So they are nafs related. Third panth or millet, when you have learned the moral laws and the spiritual principles, then you become solitary. So the third panth or millet community for the sealed to serve God. Solitary people, you know, to God. Twice born solitary philanthropist. So they are sealed to serve God. Rule of righteousness is buddhi virti related. So they do the, they rule over people and they enforce righteousness. Anybody who is unrighteous, who is aggressor, then in India, in the Middle East, the word of the mouth was enough, as to Judas Iscariot, when Jesus rebuked him, then he, when he got the money and all that, and when Jesus died, then that was enough for him to kill himself. But in India, the Satan is very powerful. Satan of Khatri tribe. And in Middle East, it was Judah tribe people. So over there, the word of mouth was not enough. So the sword power had to be used. So there were a third community of Khalsas. Khalsas are militant who do philanthropic work. They don't work for money, but they carry sword, and anybody who cannot be sorted by the word of mouth, then they sort him by the sword power. Then the fourth community is of the apostles, those who preach, those who teach the moral laws to the once born and preach gospel to the twice born. So this panth or community or millet for the thrice born saints. Remember, you become thrice born. If God be willing, he give you his very spirit, Holy Spirit, then you are thrice born. At Pentecost, then at when Jesus had trained his laborers so well, and they were with him faithful. So at Pentecost, remember the hiring of the laborers in the vineyard of God. So at Pentecost, then they were paid their wage, which was Holy Spirit with capital S. So that is called thrice born. Because the Spirit of God is the wisest one of all. While the twice born people, they have the Spirit of man, with small s. So this is with capital S, the very Spirit of God as Christ Jesus possessed. And Christ Jesus was anointed Son of God. And the laborers and the workers, when at Pentecost they were paid, they were the not anointed sons of God, just sons of God with capital S. Same Spirit they had, Holy Spirit at Jesus. But he was anointed, but they were not. So all the 12 at Pentecost, they became Christ's, not saint. Saint is a word which is used for people who earn their own spirituality through meditation and through pondering. But this one, they were preached gospel. So the people who preach gospel, they are called Christ. So they became Christ. As you have students in the university, professor teach them, and when they learn, they can become teachers. Same way, Christ Jesus was a preacher, anointed preacher or anointed royal high priest. So when he trained his laborers so well that at the Last Supper, they were so well trained that if a stranger come to find out which one is the real Christ Jesus, he would not have found him. But that's why they have to hire Judas Iscariot to catch Christ Jesus. So this fourth one is for the thrice born saints, apostles, RF, they ponder over his word, as that is called Chitvirti, purely soul related. That means it has no connection with the flesh. These people do not carry their tribal identity with them. They have nothing to do with it, but at the same time they can't conceal it. If you ask them in which tribal home you were given the birth, then they tell you. Otherwise they say we are not bothered. And these people are not bound by any moral laws. Remember that our Father God is not bound by any moral laws. He has no laws. Some people then say, you know, laws are created by God. These laws are the God related. No, they're wrong. God does not make any law, because if he makes law, then he is to be bound by them. If he is to be bound by them, then he is no more free man. So our Father is a free man, and he sets us free. That is, we also are not bound by the law anymore. We are no more slaves to the sin, but to the righteousness. That is what Christ Jesus came to deliver to us, that we should be righteous and not to bother about these rituals of the sin and all that. So this we have the again. First community is for the Homebirthi people. Birthi means state of soul, Home means ego. Second one is Manbirthi. Man stands for mind. And the third one is the Buddhi. Buddhi means wisdom, Birthi. And the fourth one is Chit Birthi. Chit means whatever you think in your heart, it is done. So you don't need to speak from your mouth. So that's why it's called Chit Birthi. In Arabic, they call it Khyal. So number A, their spiritual states. First one is ego, Home, or is called Khudi in Arabic. Then second one is mind, man, or nafs in Arabic. Third one, wisdom, which is buddhi, or we call it akal in Arabic. Then we have fourth one, which is will. Whatever he willeth, that is done. Will, chit, or khyal, the same thing, you know. Then you have B, their selves pertaining to the above states, outwardly concrete physical self, which we call asthul roop. Roop means self, asthul means solid, which you can touch, you know. Outwardly abstract spiritual self, sukshma roop, it should be inwardly, sorry. Inwardly spiritual self, that is a Jewish one who is inwardly, and not outwardly. So this is the Sukshum self. Self, it is abstract. Then the third community, philanthropist, spiritual self, Karan Roop. I will discuss this thing in the next video.